Yo, so you seen Endgame?
Yeah.
Cool.
Yeah.
Cool.
Yeah. I'm also an anchor
Oh, really?
on the Friday
Friday show.
show.
Oh, me too. Welcome to another Friday show, Padres. Today is gonna be a great one.
We have a segment on volleyball by Chase.
And we have Ben and Brian doing a segment on AirPods.
Only on
the Friday show.
Looks like those desert shippers had an awesome time in Joshua Tree.
Thanks for coming out last night to Empty Bowls to support the Monterey County Food Bank. A special thanks to Ms. Vita and all those who organized it.
Also thanks to Mr. Russell and Ms. Letterly for organizing the annual Carmel High Art Show. It is on display in the theater lobby through Monday. Check out the amazing talent of our Carmel High artists. Make sure to go, Padres.
Now, let's see what's happening with sports today. What's up, Swan and Elias?
Yeah.
What's up, Padres? I'm Elias.
And I'm Solana.
And we're here with some sports news today.
Yep, for sports today, first we got boys and girls swim versus JV Peacock at Hartnell. Release at 1:15, depart at 1:30, and meet starts at 3.
Varsity boys lacrosse versus Cardinal Newman at home at 3:30. Make sure to come check it out. That's senior night. Release at 2:15.
Varsity baseball versus Archbishop Mitty at Archbishop Mitty. Release at 1:15, depart at 1:30, game starts at 4.
Track and field PCAL Mission Championships at King City. Release at 1, depart at 1:15, meet at 4.
Boys volleyball versus PCS at home. JV game at 5 and varsity at 6:30.
And for tomorrow, we have the JV boys volleyball second annual Padre Classic starting at 8 a.m.
Also tomorrow, boys and girls swim PCAL varsity championships at Hartnell. Meet starts at 9 a.m.
Good luck
to
Padres.
All of you guys.
My name is Israel Ricardez. I go by Coach Izzy. I am the Carmel High School boys volleyball coach and the girls volleyball coach. This is my 10th season. Season's going pretty good so far. You know, when you're trying to look at the whole of where we started off really relying on guys that were coming from JV to fill in starter roles and play starter minutes. And you can see that we went through our growing pains early. We've had a really long and tough season. We're sitting at 25-9 right now with 3 games left and hoping to play deep into playoffs. But the team's improved a lot drastically, and it's really just come down to practice.
The season's going really well. We have won every game, except for Christopher, but we're playing them again soon. You should come out to that game. The team chemistry is awesome. After practice, we play basketball sometimes. It's a fun time.
Team chemistry has been great. You know, I think we all get along like we're brothers. I feel like this is maybe the closest I felt with the team personally, as far as I'm not just a coach, but I'm kind of like that big brother role and stuff for some of these guys. And I really appreciate it. It's a lot of fun for me. I think it keeps the vibe energetic. I think it keeps it fun, keeps it light, but we're also really motivated. We all want to win. We all want to be successful, and bringing home championships is a way that we prove our success around here. So it's fun to buy into all of that.
Great segment, Chase. You did a great job, and I'm so proud of you. Dress code update.
Dress code update.
Yeah.
With the sun out again, please remember to adhere to the dress code as you think through your outfit for the day. Tube tops may not be worn at school unless something like a jacket or flannel is over the top. Also, pants and shirts must touch when standing so that no midriff shows.
Prom paperwork is now due. Please turn in your permission slips to Mrs. Vita to sign up for a bus. If you are bringing an off-campus or underclassman guest, complete the guest contract and turn in their permission slip as well. Extra permission slips are on the My School homepage.
If you're going to prom and want to make a song request, you must do so today on My School. Find the link under the prom promo. Make one or more song requests. We are getting close, Padres. Remember, check in for prom. Is at 4 p.m. on Saturday, May 4th, at the CHS Theater Lobby.
Next week, we will have a double block week for SBAC math testing. Monday will be a regular 7-period day. Tuesday and Thursday will be office hours in periods 2, 4, and 6. Wednesday and Friday will be blocks 1, 3, 5, and 7. And the next 2 weeks will have no blocks.
Carmel High School is participating in Monterey County High School voter registration competition until today. Your social studies teacher can provide you with a link or find it on your CHS website to register to vote. If you have moved or changed party affiliation from the last time you pre-registered or registered, you must do it again.
Now let's see what's happening with the clubs. Club time.
Hey Padres, we got some club meetings for you today. First off, we got Ethics Bowl in room 25, as well as a meeting on Saturday, as well as chamber music in room 35.
We also have Art Club in room 16, Cyber Patriots in room 6, and Fashion Club in room 38.
Today is the continuing of the CHS Art Show until 7 p.m., with the CHS Spring Music Concert starting right afterwards and ending at 9 p.m. Come see your classmates' creative works and musical talent.
Hey everyone, Brian Porter here, and I'm here to talk to you all about an epidemic. AirPods. Now some brilliant person must have thought, man, I really don't like my earbuds being all tangled and stuff. As a byproduct of these things being created, we also have people trying to sneak them into class with their hair, thinking they're all sneaky-like. So I'm going to go ask some teachers what they think about these monsters.
I think if they use them judiciously, they're awesome. I think it can really help kids focus and read.
Well, I'm sure like anything, it can, you know, anything that takes students' attention away from their coursework is both tempting to the students and a great source of distraction. So it's just another thing for teachers to be on the lookout for, just to help support their students and make sure that they're actually paying attention to what they're supposed to be getting done.
I think there's a time and a place for them, and I think that part of being in high school is like learning when's the appropriate time to use this tech and when is not the appropriate time.
So maybe I'm just wrong about AirPods. It's more than just a piece of hardware that distracts you from your learning. Maybe it's a social status sort of thing. Right here I have my very own earbuds. I'm going to make my own AirPods, and I'm going to see if it really does make me a god. People are gonna be so jealous. Finally.
Yeah. Oh, okay.
We're gonna check out if this person. Hey, they don't fall out, man. Oh. They don't fall out. They don't look.
Oh, that's cool. That's awesome, man.
Seniors, sign up with Miss Vita for Senior Surge Day on Friday, May 10th, and we'll be helping out the MCOE Field Day. You can earn 10 hours of community service.
If you want to speak at graduation, submit your speech by April 26th, and auditions are on May 2nd.
If you have not picked up your graduation attire, see Miss Brazil in the office.
For seniors who have participated in 4 or more CHS drama productions, go see Miss Paletti so you can receive a plaque at Performing Awards Night.
If you want to show your colors, May 3rd is the Senior Decision Day, so wear the gear of the school you'll be attending next year.
Now back to the studio for birthdays.
Birthdays today. On today we have Kristen Anderson, Mackenzie Scatini, Josiah Sullivan, and Zachary Turner. You all share birthdays with Channing Tatum and Melanie Trump.
And over the weekend, we have Olivia Kadush, Camera Hira, Alabama Ledbetter, and Luke Melcher.
We all hope you guys liked today's Friday show, and let us know if Chase McChrystal should never be in another Friday show ever again.
What?
Have a great Friday, Padres.
They were singing, bye-bye, Miss American Pie. Drove my Chevy to the levee, but the levee was dry. Them good old boys were drinking whiskey and rye, singing, this'll be the day that I die.
I'm Jill Coughlin.
My name is Michelle Verbeck. I am the assistant coach for the Carmel girls lacrosse team.
In general, I've been coaching for 2 years, unless we count when I coached my sister's team.
but you know, I was 15 and she was 10, so.
So I've been coaching for about 6 years. I've been coaching here for 2 years. Prior to that, I was coaching at Virginia Wesleyan University for a Division III college.
Natural highs. Some people have them, some people are still searching. I've interviewed two students at Carmel High to talk about theirs.
My name is Zach Brady. I'm a junior at Carmel High.
My name is Sam Rao. To have a natural high for something is that you love it and love doing it, and it makes you happy when you're doing this certain thing.
Is something that you really enjoy and can lean on and have fun with that just makes you, you. My natural high is surfing. My favorite part about surfing is probably just being out there with all of my friends and just splashing around, having a jolly old time.
I experience natural highs when I snowboard, when I cliff jump, mountain bike, rock climb, being in nature. That brings me joy and love, and those are my natural highs.
As you can see, both of these students have found their natural highs through doing something they love.
This year it's a really small class, so it's a pretty intimate environment. We all get to know each other pretty well.
3/4 of the time it's really loose and everybody's pretty relaxed, talking to one another, sitting where they want. 1/4 of the time it's deadline week, and I kind of take on the role of beast master, making sure that all the stories get finished in a timely fashion.
A lot of like trying to make sure people get their art in on time, trying to place it all. Then there are inevitably like a bunch of issues that come up when we try to like load the PDF, and then it's usually right down to the wire when we publish. It's like right on the deadline, but it's a satisfying feeling.
Because if they're half as full, they're half as heavy. This is not showing up in a video.
Mr. Palshaw is just really himself.
Good afternoon, everybody, and welcome to the case of the people of the state of California versus Reagan.
The 2019 Carmel mock trial team has achieved what no other school in the Monterey County has done before by winning the county competition and moving on to state for the 5th year in a row. Tyler Armstrong also won an individual award for Best Defense Motion Attorney at state. The team also did some charity work by organizing clothes at a local food bank. Today, I wanted to interview some of the members of the mock trial team and talk with them about their favorite parts about state.
My favorite part about state would probably be the check-in the day after we learned that we did not make it to the finals, because it made everyone feel a lot better about their team in general. It just helped us build more character as a team.
My favorite part about state was eating food with the team, because that was a lot of fun. And I'm excited next year to win.
I think my favorite part of state was just building our bonds, like getting so much closer after we were all sick together and just working really hard.
Yeah, I think I'd probably say a similar thing. Like I really liked how we all came together and still did really well, even though half the team was sick. It didn't hurt us at all.
Even though the team battled sickness, they managed to excel in the competition and got 4th place. Well done, Padres.